Hi, I'm Sangeeta S Bahl. I am one woman rolled into so many roles. I'm an entrepreneur who runs impact image consultants, the pioneer leading image consultancy firm in India, and a mountaineer who believes that no heights are too high to reach. And I recently climbed Mount Everest at the age of 53. I'm 54 now. My hope to everybody who's listening to me is to say, let age never be a barrier to achieve what you want to achieve. I'm an explorer by heart. Anything or any opportunity that comes my way, I like to take it. Because I think life is too short to wait for something perfect to happen. So my life has been like this from the beginning. And climbing also happened very much the same way when I was nearly 47. And my husband asked me to accompany him to Kilimanjaro to tick off his bucket list to climb that mountain. We both exercised for about 4.5 months, lost some weight, and continued our journey and climbed the peak on 31st December 2011. And while I came down, I realized that this was going to be possible, but I had to experiment to learn more about technical climbing, because Kilimanjaro was a trek up at high altitude. It was 19,341 feet. And I came back and found out that technically it was not going to be possible unless I was trained. And then I found a mentor who trained me in Manali, in Himachal, for 12 days in deep snow, facing every kind of weather, and showed me the ropes of technical climbing, the ice axe, and whatever that was needed. Because the Darjeeling Institute of Mountaineering did not accept me because I was over 40. But that was not going to change my mind, because I had made my choice to climb the seven summits. You have to be prepared for the risks, and which really means that you know that there is going to be times when you have to not only face the harsh weather, the cold, you know, get exposed to hypothermia, and also frostbite in such cases. But if you are prepared for such a eventuality, you can only imagine it, then you are mentally also making yourself ready for such things. And let me tell you, after Kilimanjaro, climbed Mount Everest in Europe, the highest peak in Europe, in Russia, then moved on to Antarctica. I became the third Indian woman to climb Antarctica and Mount Vinson. It was minus 48 at the summit. Everything was okay because I was prepared, and I knew that wearing the right gear and you know, being mentally prepared to face any eventuality was going to happen. But on my fourth peak in Mount McKinley, and we talked about six peaks that I have done, so it's on the fourth peak that I did not summit, because my feet had got cold and I decided to turn around hardly 2 hours away from the summit. And it was very, very dejecting for me, because I said I was that close and I have to come back, but I had to take a call. But you know, it was a disaster from day one. I had issues with that climb from the beginning. And on the way back, at 16,000 feet, it was like almost a vertical head wall, that my foot got entrenched in very, very deep snow above my thigh, and I could not retract it. And by the time I retracted, it just cracked, and ACL of my right knee got completely torn, and I had to limp and fall down and just everything possible, and reached 14,000, the camp, base camp there at McKinley, to come and basically see what was wrong. Then found out nothing was broken. There are no doctors there. It is a very alpine sort of a mountain. And I had to be put in a sled And in that sled, they wrapped me in a blanket and brought me down from 14,000 to 7,000 feet. For 13 hours, I was like that. But when I came back, I realized that I had other mountains to do, because fourth was picked off, I did not climb, and my fifth was come next year. This was in July 2014, and 15 I was set to climb another one. So I came here and got my knee operated, and I was given this stick to hold, and then found out that I was not going to be dependent on the stick. I had to really do something about it. With intense physiotherapy and getting myself surrounded with positive people everywhere, I realized that I'm going to beat the odds and do something. Even my surgeon told me that, Sangeeta ma'am, now you just take it easy, 9 months, just water the plants. And within 6 months of my knee operation and physiotherapy and the right mindset, I climbed my highest ever at Mount Aconcagua, South America, in Argentina, at 22,847 feet. And that was my best gift to myself. I had just turned 50 2 weeks later. My first attempt to Everest was in 2017, and in 17 everything was alright. I had really trained well. I had climbed 2 6,000 meter peaks, one in Nepal, one in India in Ladakh, so Kampi and Loguche peak, and I thought I was ready, and I was when I reached there. But like, risks can happen, and 51 days on the mountain at Mount Everest, you have to continuously basically stay at the base camp, then go up through this Khumbu icefall, which is really, really dangerous. It's got fear lurking at every doorstep. Literally, you've got these icefall which can suddenly break and cut you to pieces, and you will never be found again. And I managed to do that for 51 days, getting up and down for 5 rotations, going up to camp 3 at till 23,500 feet. I touched in 2017, but luck was not on my side. I got really sick. Some said it was altitude, and some said it was my stomach bug, but I was really unwell and I had to be evacuated. I was at the hospital, and the nurse asked me, "So what happened? You look okay." And I said, "Well, it was not meant to be, but I'm going to come back next year." And so I did in 2018, and this time even much more stronger than I thought. I looked after myself at high altitude. Everest Base Camp is nearly 18,000 feet, and that's our home. So I would look after myself to eat. I would save myself for any kind of infection. And looking after myself, so the self-care about as you grow older is so important. And in the mountains, of course, it was 100 times more, because you were dependent on so many things. And for the time in 2018, I again went to the icefall, but this time I was really, really successful, because if you include all the icefall trips, I made about 11 of them before I finally reached the summit. The winds on the mountain are so severe that it can literally wipe you away if you are not conscious of where you are stepping. So it was one step after another, and then it is the same in real life. Every day your step towards your health or aging gracefully happens with what you put in your mouth and how you think it's going to affect your body. And I would even meditate. So meditation was a huge success for me, because every day I would meditate, and Everest was a spiritual journey for me. So I felt that the universe was with me. So the seventh peak, Mount McKinley, waits for me in 7 weeks from now. I have given or rather I'm giving everything that I've got because I know I want to raise our tricolor there. There is no oxygen needed, but it is extremely cold and I have to carry a lot of weight. So my outdoor training usually happens with backpack and pulling tires because we are on flat ground. I don't see any mountains. So I have to simulate a situation where I have to carry up to 70 kilos on this climb. So mentally I am already ready. So I exercise 4 times in the gym and 2 days outside. You know, it's very rare. We are just a handful, which is why the 50 plus club is very rare in India. And incidentally, my husband's also a climber, so we can be singled out. But age should never be a barrier to try something new. We did. I started at 47. My husband started at 50. So what's stopping anyone? It's the mind. My biggest strength is that I have never let societal pressure get me down. So for the women, I would like to say is that please don't have limited beliefs in your system. You're much more stronger than you think you are. And everything falls in place. I had the birth of my child at 38. Again, it was late according to Indian standards. But so what? Age should never let you stop doing whatever you can. Like today, I'm a mother, I'm a wife, I'm looking after a family. I'm looking after my aged parents as well. Looking after children also. And yet doing a business and climbing. So everything is possible with balance. Prioritize what you have, then prepare for it and persevere. I don't think I'm a superwoman. I think I'm just a very simple girl with extraordinary dreams. And I have never let anything come my way. You know, happy aging starts with you. Whatever women or men look for outside, it's actually all within you. Whatever knowledge that you have, please share it. No point studying so much in life and not able to share what you know. Because everybody can learn from each other. So my mantra is each one, teach one.